having the chance to speak to so many people that participate in Catholic Extension, it's wonderful to hear what people really are interested in and what they value in what we do. People just love the fact that we're training the future of the priests of our country. There are over 400 seminarians that we're helping to support, or that we're helping develop the future of youth ministry or campus ministry or all the other great ministries and missions that are so important for the future of the church. Others are just so thrilled that we continue to build churches and places where people can come together. We've built 12,000 churches by now across the country. But as we pull it all together and realize what's really at the heart of all this is that we really are building up the faith of people in the United States. And I can remember being in Camden, Mississippi, in this African-American parish in which the Catholic population in Mississippi is only about 2%. And they are absolutely convinced that they can transform the world.
Catholic Extension has been a wonderful success for Sacred Heart. You guys have helped build our church. You guys have helped build community. We have more people participating in different activities and in different ministries. We have far more people to step forward.
You know, when you're a mission diocese, the sense is that somebody has to take care of you. So the thing about Camden is that we believe we're a missionary diocese, that we have the responsibility of caring for others, and we can do that. We can build a faith community.
We can really make a difference together. What I've seen through the work of Catholic Extension is that through this partnership that we create across the country, we're able to unleash that spirit that tells somebody, I can do this. I can become more than my circumstances. What's happening is people are creating this powerful experience of faith and hope, and they keep on nurturing it in one another as they raise their children up to a different kind of vision in the world.
Right away, I kind of fell in love with the town. It's one of those places where the people struggle. They just struggle. There's alcohol and drug abuse.
I've been in and out of jail since I've been a juvenile. I've been to prison, all for drinking and driving.
One person is worth the whole world. So if you only help one person, that's fine. You've helped one person.
I haven't drank for over 2.5 years. It's something I've never had, is what the sisters helped me have. I got a foundation for my kids. I got my own house with the help of the sisters. The rest was up to me.
Somehow they have to receive from us or someone the idea that they're good and worthwhile and they're worthy of being loved. And then we show them love and they know that that's good, that's possible.
When we talk about igniting change, the image is of fire. And in a very personal way, I think it's that discovering that fire that's within you. I still picture this young man that's creating this powerful regional youth ministry in Montana. And this young man is on fire. And he discovered within him this ability to really touch the lives of others.
Normally what you see in Mass is kids who, you know, are falling asleep and don't want to be there, or, you know, being dragged there by their parents. But that's not the case. We're seeing a trend of youth who are taking ownership of their faith, and that's exciting. That's really exciting in the Catholic Church. We wouldn't be able to do what we do in Cairo without Catholic Extension. They offer us a grant that makes it financially feasible for us to combine and do multi-parish ministry.
The life of faith is two banks of a river, and on one bank is baptism or conversion, and the other bank is salvation. The Lord says, jump in the water. Extension Society meets us in the water. I think that there's this sense of a hand that says, even though sometimes you're on unstable ground, well, I will walk with you.
Growing up as a kid, there would be this magazine that would arrive at the house, and it said Catholic Extension on it. I always saw it on the kitchen table. I can't say that I knew a lot of what this Catholic Extension Society was, but that was the first time, I guess, I really heard about it. Everybody has this idea that, you know, Extension is, well, it's the big city going out and doing something for, you know, these little remote areas. And I tell you, after being there, I thought to myself, you know, who's missioning to who? We went into areas that I had never heard of before. Churches out in the backcountry of the United States. I discovered a little bit more in terms of what Extension was about. If we talk about faith that transforms, I think Extension helps to make church happen and to make transformation possible. I suppose the other thing that really captured me was going to another part of Montana called Browning, to this little church of Little Flower. The absolute spirit and the challenges that they have and the high unemployment in this small area, but yet here is this church that is the center of hope in the middle of this small town. Through courage and vision and passion, they decide they're going to open a school, a Catholic school. And they're doing it. And I don't know how they're doing it, but they're doing it.
Everything you see, our CCD center, this church, the office, our dwellings, extensions built. Sister Edna does them. It's, I mean, you can kind of get emotional there too. Sister Edna's salary is paid by Extension Society. Everything we have is funded, you know, by the Extension Society. This parish would not exist. We have the energy, we have the faith, we just don't have any money. There would not be the Catholic faith as dynamic as it is without what the Extension Society is doing for us.
It's the tens of thousands of people of Catholic Extension that believe that the light of Christ is meant to be strong in our own country, in our own people. And believe that wherever that light shines, it's a powerful reflection of God's light.
The American Catholic Church is one of the most talented and generous and passionate group of people. And I think to try to mobilize those resources and to do something in which we're all in this together is a great opportunity for us right now.